Let's take a look at configuring InTouch HMI using the configurator. At the end of an installation, you're prompted to open the configurator by clicking Configure, and the configurator opens. Alternatively, after installation is complete, sometime in the future, if you need to access the configurator from the Start menu, go to the AVEVA folder and launch configurator from this option. Configurator is typically configured top to bottom, going group to group, node to node, until all the items that you require are configured. To see a legend for how the icons are used, you can click on any group node, and the legend here at the bottom will show you what all of the icons mean. Let's begin then under the Common Platform group, and I'll select this license mode. Depending on how you licensed your software, you'll select Perpetual for a traditional non-expiring license, Flex for a subscription-based license that uses Flex credits, and Operations Control if you've acquired the license as part of an Operations Control subscription. The Connected Experience option requires that you have a Connect account and that you've enabled SSO or single sign-on across the products in this node and any related Connect Cloud services. I'm going to use the Flex license, so I'm just going to click Configure and Yes to confirm that a reboot will be required at the end. Next, we have the System Management Server. You can only have one System Management Server per system. The System Management Server's role is to manage encryption with communication between nodes and also to deal with single sign-on features. As I only have this one primary node in the network, I'm going to select that this machine is the System Management Server and click Configure. A certificate is automatically assigned to me and that value is displayed here. Next, we have the Federated Identity Provider. If you're using an external authentication, you can choose that from here, Azure Active Directory or AVEVA Connect. I'm not using one, so I'm going to choose none and click Configure. Next, we have the group for AVEVA Enterprise Licensing. This first node is a warning that your license server is not yet secured. You click Configure to secure it. And it reports back that the license server is configured in secured mode. Next up, we have Select License Server. Typically, one node in the network will serve as the license server. If you can make a successful connection to it, the test connection will indicate that it has succeeded, which you can see in this message down here at the bottom of the configuration messages. And when ready, click Configure. The next group, Industrial Graphics Server, is InTouch specific. Though it's already configured, I will make a mention here that client settings relates to the web client tool. It is basically the rate at which animations are refreshed and alarm information is updated, and these can be adjusted here in milliseconds. And then we have the authentication settings. This is again used by web client to establish user authentication. It is using Windows authentication. This next group, AVEVA System Platform, are required components even though System Platform was not selected during this installation. So ideally, you select each one of them and click Configure to complete these mandatory required pieces. So the Application Server, gRPC, and the Identity Manager Registration. Next up, we have the AVEVA Historian group. The server configuration, most applicably to InTouch HMI, deals with this high-speed history blocks usage for things like the alarm client events and alarm storage. We'll configure that. And similarly, we will accept defaults on the security node for configuring Historian, on the search index for Historian, and finally, for reporting purposes. For this next group, AVEVA System Monitor, I did not install System Monitor, so I will just disable this local agent and click Configure. And finally, this last group, AVEVA InTouch HMI, has a configuration item for the Identity Manager Registration, and I'll go ahead and click Configure to make sure that that's available for use. Once all the nodes in the tree have been marked as completed, you can click Close. And if this is the configurator at the end of the installation, you're prompted to restart now so you can begin using the software. If you were starting the configurator from the Start menu to make changes, then you would not receive this prompt.